Hello, my name is V Dong. I'm so excited to tell you about an anteater virtue that will help you succeed in college and beyond. Intellectual tenacity. To understand the power of intellectual tenacity and how to apply it to your life, we'll take a look at the life of one of history's most courageous and persistent scientists, Marie Curie. Curie defied the world's expectations of women and overcame obstacles to reveal the fundamental truths about atoms, the tiny building blocks that make up everything around you. Born in Poland in 1867, Marie graduated at the top of her class in high school, yet she was not allowed to enroll at the university, which was for men only. Marie and her sister made a pact that they would take turns working to support each other's dream to get a college education abroad. Marie worked as a tutor for 5 years to support her sister. During this time, she took underground courses in secret. Finally, Marie had the chance to go to university in Paris. After graduation, she became fascinated by a puzzle raised by a physicist named Henri Becquerel. Why did a mysterious material called uranium emit light? Marie came up with an original hypothesis. Perhaps the uranium atom was undergoing a spontaneous change in its structure that caused it to shine light. Marie's idea was revolutionary because all the experts assumed atoms were indivisible and could not undergo change. Marie set out to find proof for her idea, which she coined radioactivity. Alongside her scientist husband, Pierre, she spent 4 years in a broken down shed, boiling and extracting a mineral called pitchblende. She discovered new radioactive elements, including polonium, which Marie named after Poland, and radium. On the basis of her work on radioactivity, she became the first woman in France to get a PhD. Later that year, she won the 1903 Nobel Prize in Physics, along with Pierre and Henri. Marie faced more challenges, but they couldn't stop her from investigating radioactivity. A horse carriage accident killed Pierre, leaving Marie a widow with two young daughters. As if being a single mom and heading a research institute wasn't hard enough, Marie became a public figure who the haters were gonna hate. Newspapers published hurtful stories about her private life, and to top it off, a physicist by the name of Lord Kelvin challenged Curie's theory of radioactivity. He proposed that radium wasn't an element, but a material made up of two elements, lead and helium. If Curie was arrogant or closed-minded, she would have dismissed Kelvin and his proposal. On the other hand, if she were insecure, she may have given up on her idea. After all, Kelvin was a famous man and people called him Lord. But being intellectually tenacious, Marie took Kelvin's idea into account and set out to disprove his theory with evidence. After many more years of work, she determined radium's position on the periodic table, proving beyond doubt that radium was an element. For this breakthrough, Marie won a second Nobel Prize in chemistry. She remains the only person in history to win Nobel Prizes in two different sciences. In case you're wondering, Marie proves it is possible to do well in a double major. Despite being a two-time winning Nobel laureate, Marie did not rest on her laurels. In the midst of World War I, she developed the use of X-rays for medicine. She taught herself human anatomy and how to drive. She drove her mobile X-ray stations to diagnose wounded soldiers on the front lines. Curie blazed her own pathway and broke barriers, especially for women who dreamed of becoming scientists. Here we are on Curie Court in University Hills, named after Marie Curie, who blazed her own pathway and broke barriers for women, especially those who dreamed of becoming scientists. Now that you've learned about Marie Curie, you may be wondering, how am I supposed to practice intellectual tenacity at UC Irvine? Don't worry, we're not expecting you to spend the next 4 years in a poorly ventilated shed using a cauldron to isolate radioactive elements, unless you think that sounds fun. We do expect, though, that you, like Marie Curie, will develop the complementary virtues of humility and tenacity. This balance was one of the most valuable lessons I learned as a college student right here at UCI. I grew up in a large extended family where my relatives liked to call my sister the pretty one and me the smart one. I was happier about this than my sister. Being the first person in my family to go to college, I didn't know what to expect, what I wanted to major in, or how to talk to professors. I found them too intimidating. I was surprised at how fast-paced my college courses were compared to high school. Shouldn't this be easier, I wondered? Wasn't I supposed to be the smart one? One day, I was walking across Aldridge Park. I was visibly upset and ran into Wilmer, a classmate from my chemistry class. He asked me what happened, assuming something truly terrible. I confided, "I got a very bad grade." Wilmer seemed relieved, and so I explained, "How can I get a D on an essay about the Vietnam War? I've never gotten anything below an A minus in my life. Plus, I'm Vietnamese." Of course, being Vietnamese and even having a father who fought in the war alongside American troops didn't make me an expert. I forced myself to go talk to my professor, have a more open mind, and consider other perspectives. To make a long story filled with obstacles short, I passed the class, became a professor of chemistry, not history, and married Wilmer. We have a son who's taught me that the master virtue of curiosity is innate. Liam was born wanting to know everything there is to know about trains, trucks, and rocket ships. Aside from teaching and research in chemistry, I've also become quite the expert on backhoe loaders. Today, I lead a research team that studies a branch of science called organic chemistry. Organic chemistry deals with all things made of carbon. The same way virtues are a sweet spot between having too much or too little of a trait, carbon is a sweet spot among the 118 elements. Carbon atoms make up your food, fuels, and medicines. Many people assume that scientists look something like Albert Einstein. In reality, my laboratory is a group of young people, mostly in their 20s. They impress me every day with their tenacity in dealing with failed experiments, exploring their own ideas, and mastering new skills. My research team is passionate about inventing environmentally friendly ways to build molecules. As you start this exciting chapter in your education, remember that grit is a more important predictor of your success than talent. Expect that you will struggle to understand an idea or even struggle to pass a course. You'll need the right dose of humility to learn from mistakes and embrace different ideas. Don't be too proud to ask questions and get help from your classmates, TAs, and professors. We would love to see you at office hours. At the same time, believe in yourself. Regardless of what life throws at you, believe you will find a way around these obstacles to reach your dreams. Believe you will make the world a better, more inclusive, equitable, and sustainable place for everyone. Like Marie Curie's radioactive elements, you will transform and you will shine. Whatever you've been labeled in your past, whether you were the athletic, the artistic, the pretty, or the smart one, it's time to embrace your future as a UC Irvine anteater, the humble and tenacious one. Shine bright, anteaters. Zot, zot, zot.